Hey, Josh friends, how are you? Today I'm gonna do another game here of the World Chess Championship in 1894 between Lasker and Steinitz. The game 3. Opening is Roy Lopez, Steinitz defense, the white pieces Lasker and black pieces Steinitz. Let's go for the first move. A4, 5. D6, Bishop C4, different variation this time. Exchange knights early on. Bishop A6. Challenge for a bishop trade. Don't forget the coins here. If Lasker takes the bishop, be an open file on the F file. Threatening the knight. C4, queen escapes the G3. Knight B6. E bishop A3. C6 and pawn advances to F5 to threaten the bishop. Bishop captures on B3. Rook captures. Rook's pawn captures. Knight D7 and Bishop F4, threatening to capture on D6. Queen defends the D6 pawn. B4. E2, with an intention to go to E6, pretty attractive spot for the white knight on A6. Queen B6, threatening the knight, and Lasker defends the knight on C3, find its castle screen side. And there goes the sweet spot for the knight. Knight on e6. Rook moves. An excellent move by Lasker. Now, threatening the queen and also the pawn on a7. Queen moves, and so Lasker takes the pawn. Pawn b6 and check. Rook a8. Rook captures f8 and you can see that Steinitz is a piece down. I'm gonna go back a little bit on the move prior to the check on Rook A8. So after Rook captures pawn, Black could move here and that seems to be more defensive, avoiding the check on A8. Get the coins, Lauren. Yeah, but that was not the choice. So let's go back. Get the coins, Lauren. Coins. Where's your coins? Can't do the laundry without the coins. Queen d3. Black starts to attack. Rook f1. Okay, queen c2. Black is threatening a checkmate with his knight on d3, and so Lasker covers his bishop. Captures knight a6. Queen takes e4, check. Queen trade. Declines the queen trade. Queen captures g2. Pawn d3. Rook e8. Black is planning to move his rook to a8, and then to a1 check or a2 to attack the 7th rank. Challenges the queen for a trade. Black queen declines. King d1. Now here comes the rook. a8. Rook f2. Rook a2. b5. Pawn c5. Knight captures on g7. Pawn d5. King c1. Getting closer to the rook. Okay. Black proposes a queen trade, but a forking check after. Captures. Check. Check again. Force move, only one move. Captures b3. f3, threatening the knight. c4, defending the knight. Knight e8, threatening to capture pawn on f6, and also a check. D6. Knight B4. Rook G3. Check. Again, check again, sacrifices a rook for a knight. Knight takes f6. Takes b5. for the promotion. D4. Black threatens to chase the queen in pawn by moving his rook on f5. Knight g7 to prevent the rook from going to f5. Dxc3, bishop takes c3, rook c5, and going for the promotion. It's at this point that Lasker wins. Steinitz resigns.
Tomorrow I have a lucky gift card. $50. I won it, remember? Spent $8 on the con thing, on the arcade machine, and I won $50. Yeah, lucky ako. Was lucky.
Are you recording?
I don't, but I can't spend it because I don't have CVV, so.
Yeah, I'll use it.
Are you recording?
Tell me what you're gonna buy because, like, it's my money still.
I'm gonna use it. So, yeah, as we can see here. Go put the laundry in. As you can see here. Sorry, those were my kids. They're asking me about things here. Just going to put the laundry in. So where are we? So yeah, the promotion of the white pawn is unavoidable now, inevitable. So, even if it takes the bishop, check, goes here, and there's just no way. No more. Pawn is inevitable for a queen. And that's it. Okay, excellent performance here by Lasker. He dominated the game, I would say. He was always on the attack. He was a piece up and just utilize his advantage. And yeah, hope you liked the game. Please leave your comments and see you again till the next game. Have a good one. Cheers.